A trusted friend told me that he misses the narcissism in my videos, and I think he might have a point, so I will try to be less humble. I've been too humble as of late, so I will start being a bit more narcissistic. It is, after all, my way. And speaking of which, I want to remind you of something, that I am, in fact...
You're a big guy!
For you! I was on Guide to Culture yesterday and we talked about Batman, so yeah, I was in some Bane posting mode. So anyway, this is just a general health update. If you've been following me on Instagram, you've seen that I've taken a few of my butter coffees. I made a recipe on it last year for Gain's Kitchen. I can link it below if you want. So basically it's, you know, regular coffee and then a tablespoon of butter and a tablespoon of coconut oil. So I've actually started having this every day now, and I will get to the reason in a minute. But I also wanted to make this video because I have talked about intermittent fasting and coffee before, so this is sort of like an update for those videos. You can find both videos on my channel if you search. So basically, intermittent fasting is something I've done over many years, but since I have this butter coffee in the morning, it's technically not intermittent fasting anymore. But since it is only fat, basically, I'm still in ketosis, so I still have that benefit at least. But technically speaking, I'm no longer doing intermittent fasting simply because I have that coffee. And to recap the coffee video I made a while back, a year ago, I went off coffee for a few months, 6 months, then I started having a coffee each week, and then I experimented a bit with how I perform best. Is it a coffee once a week or once a day or something? And I decided upon having a coffee once a day is the optimal, and then I might have a pre-workout or perhaps a small coffee in the afternoon or something if I have slept poorly or something. But back in the day, I used to have 4 or 5 coffees even in a day. That was too much, and so I decided to go off completely. And now I have settled upon, yeah, 1 cup or perhaps 2 cups, 1 big in the morning and 1 smaller in the afternoon, or a pre-workout. You have Varulvs Brygd if you are in Sweden, of course, the best pre-workout on the market. Now, I will say also that if you do drink coffee in the morning, I personally wait 1 hour before drinking it. So I wake up at maybe 7 or 8, then I wait an hour. So if I wake up at 7, I drink it at 8 o'clock in the morning. Because you already have quite a bit of cortisol when you wake up, especially if you expose yourself to some good light. You will have those hormones working for you anyway. So it's unnecessary to have the coffee the first thing in the morning. So if you take your first cup, perhaps you're at your work or something, you can do your regular routine, get to work, have that coffee. Or if you're working from home, just wait an hour until you have it. And that's also really nice because then you have something to look forward to. So that is my update on coffee. Basically, 1 coffee each day. That's how I perform best. And that's also the best for my, you know, pleasure of life. And that's also the main reason I'd say that I take this bulletproof coffee in the morning. It's just something I enjoy so much. It makes me feel so good as well. It's something I look forward to. And, you know, as I posted on Instagram the other day, just having that coffee in the sun. Yeah, true luxury indeed. So that is why I use that coffee, pure bliss of life, so to speak. And then I also feel, you know, my energy levels really, really solid and smooth throughout the day. I will say though, if you are cutting or if you are, if you can't afford so many calories, it is a lot of calories in this particular recipe, so be cautious. If you're trying to get shredded, it might be better to just have a black coffee. So yeah, keep that in mind. But for me, as I said in the beginning, I'm a big guy, so I have, you know, quite a bit of calories to spend to get up to my maintenance level. And then if I train and if I go on a walk, etc., I can spend even more. So for me, it is acceptable. I don't know if I will keep doing it when I start to get shredded for the summer. Time will tell. I will keep you updated. So yeah, that's basically how I am doing it right now. Technically not intermittent fasting anymore because I have the coffee. It just brings me so much joy and pleasure in my life. So I decided to keep it. So yeah, that's my health update. And if you want training updates, you can head over to my Patreon or Subscribestar. I have just posted another neck routine if you want to become a human toad. I don't like pit bulls, so that's why I call it a human toad instead of a human pit bull. If you wonder what kind of dogs I like the more natural dogs, so a Siberian Husky or a Border Collie or Australian Shepherd or something like that. But I don't like pit bulls, and I don't think any one of you like it either. So we say something else to, have a thick neck instead of a pit bull. Anyway, that is a completely different topic. So anyway, I'll see you on Patreon. Have a great week ahead. XOXO, boo!